Hi everyone, welcome to the walkthrough video for the decision matrix template. If you haven't purchased this template, I will leave links in the description box so you can go ahead and grab your copy. The first tab you would see is the instructions tab. Here you would find my contact information as well as a detailed step-by-step guide that would help you get started with using this template. Before we get started with the tutorial, I want to show you what a template looks like when you purchase it. The next tab is the task and matrix. I have left some placeholders here, so when you do purchase this template, you will see these placeholders. You can go ahead and delete them and put in your own information. All right, but this is just to show you how the template is. The rest of the template would look something like this, mostly blank, except for the placeholder information. The next few tabs would be the monthly tabs, and they will more or less be blank, except for the tab that has the due dates in that month. So if we go back to the original tab, you can see that the due dates are in March, and that's the reason why we have some information here. But for the rest of the tabs, it would be blank just like this. Alrighty, so we are in the demo copy of this template. The first tab is the task and matrix tab. Here's where you set up your template as well as input your task and prioritize them. I'll give you a quick overview and then we'll go through a few examples. So first area here shows you today's date. It is automatic. And then here is your task breakdown by category. Here is a filter area that you can use to filter the task that would show up in the decision matrix, which is all the way over here. And if I click on this dropdown, you can see that you can show all of them or the different categories, and I'll show you how to edit these as well. Here we have a graph that shows you the number of tasks in each area. And then here we have the number of tasks that we haven't completed. So when the tasks flow over to the priority matrix and you cross them off, this number should decrease. Here you have the number of tasks that are overdue. Right now we say zero tasks overdue, but if I were to change one of these dates to a date in the past, so let's do November, now it shows one task overdue. This bottom section is where we would input all of our tasks, set a category, assign the due dates, assign if they're urgent or important. And if you scroll all the way down, you see it stops at 50, but you can expand this. When you try to expand this, it will show an error message, and that is because there's a formula in this column, and this formula goes all the way down here. So when you try to expand, it's thinking that this formula is going to be affected. As long as you're not deleting or editing any formula in the template, when you get this pop-up message, you can go ahead and say don't show for 5 minutes and click OK. Then you should be able to expand it. So it goes beyond 50 tasks all the way down to 100. And actually it can be extended beyond 100 if you need to. The only thing you need to do is edit the formulas to ensure that it's copied down into the new rows. So I'll collapse this for now. So if you're only going to be using it for 50 tasks or less, just keep it collapsed. Go ahead and expand it to use it beyond 50 tasks. We have these four sections: do now, the later, delegate, and the last one is delete. Each one has its own graph that shows you the number of tasks that has been entered and the number of tasks that are left. As you can see, there are 5 tasks here. If I were to cross one off, this number decreases, and it also calculates a percentage done, which is 1 out of 5, 20%. Okay, so next we're going to add a task to the task list. But before doing that, let me quickly show you how to add or edit the categories. Go ahead and click on this dropdown. You can see the list of categories we have. Click on this edit button, and you can see we have home, leisure, project, work. You can always delete this, type in a new category. So let's say school, and you can add a new one, meeting. And then you have to assign a color here and click on done. Once you do this, it will ask you if you want to apply to all the dropdowns. Go ahead and say apply to all. And now what you're going to see are some error messages. The reason why we're seeing these error messages is because we removed leisure from the dropdown categories. Go ahead and reassign that task to the new categories. So now let's go ahead and add in a new task. I'm going to type in task number 21. All right. And assign a new category. I'm going to assign meeting. And assign a date by double clicking in this cell. The calendar is going to show up, navigate to the date you want, and click on it. Before you do anything, you're going to see that delete has automatically been assigned, and that's because delete means the task is not important and it's not urgent. So let's assume this task is urgent and important, so we're going to click on both, and then we scroll over to this area. You should be able to see the task showing up right here with the due date here. All right, so if we go back and let's say now this task is urgent but not important. Okay, so we're going to uncheck this and it automatically defaults to delegate. And if we go to the delegate section, the task should show up right here. Let's change this to a date in the past. Let's say November 30th. Okay. And if we go here, you can see now shows up in this red color to signal to you that it is overdue. Sticking with this delegate, if I check this box, you can see it says I have 5 tasks left. And that's because I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 tasks left. So essentially, every time I check it off, this graph grows and this shrinks. Here we have a due date of November 30th and November 1st that is overdue. And if I scroll here, it should say I have two tasks overdue. If I cross this off, it's going to say I have one task overdue because even though this has a due date in the past, the task is considered done. The last thing I want to show you before we move on to the monthly tabs is this task will not be removed automatically from these sections until you delete them from here. So let's say we are done with task number one. We want to delete that. It still shows up here. Go ahead and just highlight the task and highlight all the way through the due date. Click on delete and it disappears. Then you can uncheck boxes and you can use this space for a new task. And as you can see, the task no longer shows up here. All right. So that is how you would use this template. Next way to use the decision matrix, you can use it with or without a calendar. The calendar is just another way to visualize the task in your decision matrix. So you do have 12 months already provided for you, so you don't have to worry about duplicating the templates. It's already good to go. So click on the first month, which is January. It has already been assigned to January 2025, but this can be changed. You can change the year by selecting this drop down and selecting the year you want to use it. And you can always add more years by clicking on this edit button. Select the month by clicking on this drop down and selecting the month. If you're going to change the month, just rename it here so you don't get confused. Other than that, it's good to go. These tasks will be automatically added into the calendar, meaning that you don't really have to do anything in this tab. This tab is for you to view information and to cross them off. That's all you have to do. So if we go back to our matrix, you can see placeholder number 2 is assigned to category work due January 2nd and is under delegates. So we go to January, you can see placeholder number 2 assigned to work, delegates due January 2nd. And what's nice about this table is you can filter the task. So right now it's by default is showing all decisions and all categories. You can decide, okay, I only want to see the decisions that are assigned to delegate. So click on that and click on delegates. And as you can see, it only shows delegate both here and in the monthly area. In addition to that, you can also decide to filter by category. So if you're using this for work and school and home task, you can decide, okay, I'm home, I only want to see my task related to that category. So click on that. So let's say home, and it filters it by home. You could also sort by date by clicking on either earliest date or latest date. I'm going to reassign it to all of them. Scroll over to the monthly area. It is all color coded. So delegate would be green, do later would be orange, do now would be red, and delete would be purple. That way, even when you're looking in the calendar, you know exactly what the priority is. And once you're done with that task, you can cross it off here. The only place that you can use to remove or add a task is this table right here. Okay, so this is where you would go if you need to remove, delete, edit a task. But anything you do here will not affect the monthly tabs, and anything you do in the monthly tabs will not affect the matrix area. Okay, this is just another way that you can use to visualize your task and keep track of what you need to do and cross them off your to-do list. Now, all of the tasks are showing up here. If I go to February, for example, it's blank. But if I go back to my task, reassign some of the dates here, double click, and I'm going to choose a date in February. All right. And then assign all of these tasks to a February date. So when I go back to January, the list should be shorter. And when I go to February, you can now see I have the task shown up here. And just like the January tab, you can decide to filter by category, by task status, and also sort by latest date or earlier date. All right, so that brings me to the end of this tutorial. Like I said before, my contact information can be found here. You can send me an email as well on Etsy if you want to. And if you have not purchased this template, I will leave a link in the description box so that you can go ahead and grab your copy. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.